touch a really complicated shape. Just cutting it is going to be important, unless you really want to just grab it. Okay. I'll tell you what. Everybody's looking at me like, we have one friend who's volunteered to do it and cuts the cake. I would like to ask you to admire the cake, because it's beautiful and it was done by one of our troop members who's not here today.
You are on the cake.
Veronica. I'm on the cake. She made a little Sophie, and it's adorable. But don't eat the Sophie. It's kind of keep that. So, yes, please. So, my lords and ladies, as we spend the next 10 minutes in a little bit of an education of what is made in dell'Arte, I invite you to multitask. Go get a piece of cake and listen to me as I do a little bit of education for you about what is Commedia dell'arte. So enjoy the silly fun cake. It is beautiful and it really represents the whole essence of Commedia. So Commedia dell'arte is 16th century theater. It was one of the first times that anybody could make a living doing theater, because it started in the marketplace as ways for merchants to gain attention and get other people to their booths, and it grew from there into a profession. It was also one of the first times women were welcomed into a theater profession. You had many different ways to see performing happen. This was improvised. That's one of the ways that we identify comedia. It's improvised and it's comedy. It happened in the street, and also the more professional groups got patrons and they could rent theaters and they became very respectable. So you have a whole spectrum of ways that this theater style was experienced. It began in Italy and all the Italian city-states, mostly in northern Italy, and it expanded from there. Now, one of the other key features of Commedia is the use of stock characters. You will see the same characters used over and over again, but with different relationships. All of these characters have very consistent personality traits and costuming. In the early days of Commedia, which is around the middle of the 1500s, you saw these characters start to develop and they became more consistent throughout history. In the SCA time period, they were still more flexible. So we have a lot of artistic interpretation that we are free to do, but still being historically accurate. So there are some ways these characters show up. And you, as the audience, will have a relationship with these characters. I will encourage you to hiss and boo and cheer according to what the characters need from you. So I will tell you the first, most important character, the patriarch of all of Commedia, the number one most important, is our man Pantalone. Now, oh yes, yes, he makes you. Oh, Pantalone. Oh, it's good to see you. I'm glad you're here. I was just telling everyone about you.
Of course you are, for I am Pantalone, the richest man in the city.
Oh, but how did you get so rich?
Well, I cheated people, and they gave me money, and I didn't give it back to you. Usual way.
You cheated? Oh, well,
the house is business, darling. You have to be cunning.
Yes, I suppose so. Well, a cunning man like you must have a family, I assume.
I do have a daughter.
You have a daughter?
Yes, I have a daughter. Isabella?
Isabella,
get out of here.
Isabella?
Isabella is my daughter.
Oh, Isabella! Oh, you're so lovely!
Well, do you trust?
Oh, that's money. It's lovely to see you. Yes, count your money and enjoy that.
Not yet.
Ready? 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 beautiful young woman that we have ever seen. Well, I hope you find a gentleman that
I'll
could possibly, throw Cuba's arrow into your heart. Like you.
Besides, Horatio.
Yes, this cake actually over there. Yes, but you have adventures and how you have done so many chivalric things all around the world.
I have beaten thousands of armies, sailed thousands of ships.
Yes, you have. You're so impressive, Capitano. I'm doing International Commedia dell'Arte Day. What are you doing?
Going back to you.
Oh, okay. Capitano. Isn't he handsome? Oh, Capitano is so dashing and handsome. He just makes me really feel like Isabella. He's magnificent. So, my lords and ladies, we have these characters that have a relationship with you. So whenever you see someone that is a villain, that is out for selfish gain, like Pantalone, I want you to hiss. Yes. You can also this is your relationship with the characters. And when you see our heroes, like lovers, actually when you see the lovers, that should bring up for you your own feelings of love. So, perfect, did you do that again? That's beautiful. So bring forth the sighs of love in your own heart when you see the lovers. Let's practice together. 1, 2, 3. That's beautiful. Cute! And then we have our heroes. There are a number of them. Whichever one inspires you, when you see a hero, I want you to cheer. But it was wrong. Have you heard of the story of Don Quixote?
Yes.
Yes, you know this. Well, the story you have heard is not the true story. We will tell you, exactly, we will tell you the truth today about why the poor man, Alonso Cuarón, went mad and turned himself into Don Quixote. It is, in fact, a Cavadia problem that we will solve today as we bring to you the story of Arlecchino of La Mancha!
I'm sure you've read some of my books. taught him a very secret of me. But I taught him some of these things. He might have heard of them. One of them is called the ultimate threat to the calendar.
Married. Oh, I wanted to get married. I always need to get married. Is he he is vetted, because that's what's important. Yes.
Vet?
Yes, yes. Well, I can't have him just marrying any man. I mean, he could be a poet,
an axe murderer, or even a Spaniard.
An axe murderer.
Yes. I have arranged for you to marry one of the most prominent men in all Ravenna.
So I met a wonderful man yesterday in the market.
And
he was beautiful and tall and gorgeous, and he smelled wonderful.
And this man is established, he's rich, and you've known him all of your life.
Yes.
I have arranged for you to marry Dottore Grazia, yes.
Dottore!
Yes.
Oh my God, Dottore, he smells like stinky cheese. But no, he's all wrinkly and yellow.
It will grow on you.
Oh, he's so boring. I would rather marry an ex-murderer.
Well,
why would you do this to me?
You will be established as one of the preeminent women in Ravenna, and that's what is important. You will have money, and that's what you need. You need to have, and you'll get used to how he smells, and the fact that his skin kind of flakes off.
And
he smells like, he's got allergies. He must have wandered off. I really should find him. Yes. And he was telling me that he is the, he really believes that Doctor is the best individual for her. But you will just have to take my word for it.
I hope that you are keeping the happiness of your daughter in the front of your mind.
Yes, she will be rich. Yeah, now, you just go and help her. Help her get ready for the wedding.
I will get Isabella ready to be married, but not to the Tourney.
Oh! Why did I have to do this? I could have had a son. If I had a son, then I could have caroused with him and taught him the processes, you know, how to buy, cheat, and steal, you know, the art of the game. And it would work, but no, I had to have daughters. Daughters just want to buy shoes, dresses, jewelry.
I await some good news because I have been doing my preparation, eh?
Oh, yes, well.
I have been reading my books because I anticipate the finest, the most memorable, the grandest honeymoon.
I really need to tell you that I did tell Isabella.
But you see, I'm going to take her to all the famous places in all of Europe where I can see all the grandest and oldest books.
But
don't you know how I love
it? Don't you love old books, David?
Oh, smells so good. You love old books, don't you?
I, friend, we should concentrate on Isabella, and while you have wonderful ideas.
And then we're going to take a boat trip around the Greek island. I have consulted the first mate. He's a fine and mighty sailing man, and his skipper is brave and sure. I'll tell you something. It is not good to be a bachelor. Professorial, but a bachelor. I am going to be married to Isabella, and that's the news I'm anticipating.
Yes, I have to walk her.
I bet you need to be a millionaire and his wife join me on a trip around a Greek island, wouldn't you say so? It would be room for a millionaire and his wife.
How long would that take?
Isabella and the professor, Tortore, and Benedetta,
yes. So how long do you think this trip would take?
Well, I've contracted. It's about for 3 days. 3 hours. Just
3 hours. 3 hours.
3 hours. I don't want to get seasick. That's why I don't
want
to get
sick.
And then, you know, the weather might change.
Well, you know, that always
water get off.
But I should tell you.
I'm still convinced that first mate and his skipper are brave and true. And we are safe.
We will be safe.
I've contracted very well. I've done very well against contracting. See?
Yes.
It is unavoidable. So, all my honeymoon plans are all set. I've done my preparation.
Dottore, my friend, my colleague, my lawyer, I should have let you know that Isabella was not...
Isn't my money worth it? I know I've given you so much. It's a tax break. But, you know, I have told you a dowry so I can
she
pay
did not for like the fact that she was marrying you.
But it's not good for us to be bachelors. I'm not good at this. Bachelor.
My plan, let me tell you to be straight. She screamed and said no.
What could be objectionable about me, wise, intelligent? I write all the contracts. I know all the tax breaks.
I guess you do, but she said you smell like cheese.
Old cheese. But we're going to Roper, we're going to Stilton, we're going to visit Limburger.
That's all. Well, that explains all that! But surely there is something that you could do in your vast knowledge that would help her be more inclined to be men.
I'm not old, I'm positive of persuasion.
Something you could give
to
give
consulted the alchemists of Fider and Glaxo and Bayer, and I have come up with this very solution that will change my appearance so much that either you won't recognize me, but even though I think it's very good fashion, you won't even need much.
Only that much, a little blue bottle.
I'm on the verge of writing my passport.
The little blue bottle may not be right for everyone. Ask your barber if you are healthy enough to play Barley Grape. In the event the effects last longer than 4 hours, you should immediately seek chiropractic attention. Not responsible for loss of limbs or appendages, your results may vary.
Certainly. What do you think? I could make you even more well.
I can market that.
Are you sure it would work?
Oh, you will not recognize me. Trust me.
Won't recognize you. Well, we will let's go off and make arrangements for the power. Yeah.
I feel like getting married again. Yes, they say Paul Olivia's had enough husbands since 27, but I feel the need for 28. Yes, so I have my sights set on Dottore Graziano. He seems to be the most likely to, not last very much longer. And he has enough money that I suspect he will keep me in the style to which I have become accustomed. So, I must find Dottore Graziano and find a way to bring him under my spell. Because I've done it enough, and I can do it again. I'm very excited. But now I have a problem with my neighbor Pantalone. He seems to believe that his daughter would be the perfect match for Dottore. He didn't check with me first. So I have to find a way to make sure that Isabella, Pantalone's daughter, marries someone else. So I need someone that someone that might be a duke, maybe from a foreign land, like Spain. Oh, I smell.
Duke means excellent.
Well, my goodness. So, sir, I had not seen you here before.
Ah, let me introduce myself. My name is Capitano Alberto Delto Carlos Diego Faro Felipe Diego Hugo Ignacio William Thomas.
William Thomas?
William Thomas. Donna Lydia, good to meet you, 5 years.
Well, Capitano, I have never seen someone so bubble, handsome looking before.
I love being got a handsome looking.
You are exactly the kind of person I have been looking to meet. Handsome and married and not
Pantalone's house. Do you know who works at Pantalone's house? This is the best thing. Benedetta works at Pantalone's house. She is the most amazing, amazing woman. Just the smell of her with Winnie Puttanesca gets my mouth watering. That time she made that mushroom tortellini, it was like I was seeing God. Ah, I think I was seeing Benedetta.
Hello, Arlecchino. How are you?
Oh, here we go.
Awesome. Thanks. So, Arlecchino, why are you here today?
I just wanted to make sure all the preparations are in place for the wedding. Of course, you're going to be putting on the feast, right?
Okay. I will be putting on the wedding feast. Yes.
Wow.
Oh, nice to see you.
Yes. That's money. I'm so glad to see Erico. I have an interesting proposition for you. Now we've been neighbors for a long time.
Yes, and I wish we would.
Ever since my 15th husband died.
Yeah.
He was a lovely man.
Poor fellow.
So, Pantalone, I have a proposition for you, and I'm sure...
The answer is yes.
Well, then...
You will marry me?
Not yet, Pantalone. Maybe a few husbands from now. But you are looking to marry off your daughter, I know.
Yes, I am.
And I have found the perfect husband. Yes, I found him. I'm going to bring him to you right now.
Comes from a look so he's wonderful. It's Pasquale, which one over on me. Not Pasquale. Who's Oh!
Pantalone, I'm sure you know who this is. Isabella's future husband!
Well, this is different. I must say, the shoulders are...
You've never seen anything like this.
No, I haven't never seen anything. That's a win. Benedetta! Benedetta, get in here! Just hold a moment. Benedetta! Where is Isabella?
I will get her. We're going to love
Isabella. Isabella!
Sweet and quiet and visible.
Isabella! You, Benedetta, gave me the footwork of running. That is an imposter. Get him out of my house! Get him out of my
eyes! I am who I am. I have never changed the innate essence of myself.
Oh, I am bereft of my love. Ah, treachery most foul.
Oh, and it is he who gave me the directions. It must be he who steals my love from me. I must go and write love poetry and be very, very, very sad.
I swear, come over here. You surely know who this is. This is the marriage. And my decision is final.
I am so excited, my honey.
But preparation.
I will take good care of you.
She just comes out like a nova sometimes. I really don't know where she came from.
I think it was.
You know, shut up for a minute.
I've read all the romances. Even
this is the shield of Saint Sebastian. Would block 12 arrows every time. Just not the good thing. Watch out for that one. Would you like to walk?
Finish
But I've got money!
What, when you're dead, oh, you're nothing, that's enough. But until then, nobody cares.
Back up a moment. You said people say nice things about you when you go to the mansion.
Yes, when you die, people say nice things about you. Until then, you know you're a
character. Arlecchino, you're a genius! I gotta go talk to you. Go ahead.
Safety from 12 arrows.
Shall I
You shall count to 12, not to 11, only to be preceded or followed by 12, and never count to 13.
I don't. How can you count that?
And then this, this is, of course, the agony of shows. Very, very careful with that.
How does it work? Do you know?
Don't pull that. Don't pull that.
But you. Oh, no,
it's really hidden now.
You can see.
Well,
don't worry, don't worry. I must talk to you. I must talk to you right now.
Yes, yes. You need to write me an obituary.
Why do I have to write you an obituary? That's the end of our legal connection. If I write you an obituary, where will my income come from?
Well, as it is, I want you to write an obituary about me so that when people read it, they will think I'm dead, and then they will say nice things about me. So
yes,
then they will like me.
You do need some nice things said about you, and that is indeed.
Excellent
vehicle.
Yes. So you have ideas on what to say.
Ah, I'm
so comfortable. Let us go discuss it.
Obituary.
Oh, you got that.
Oh!
Yes.
Oh! Yes, I am outmatched! and then so dying because I love them. I am sure that my love will, with my last dying breath, gain my undying love and hold it with her forever while I'm dead.
Now, Orazio, don't do anything rash.
Rash?
No.
I'm only challenging two other men in a duel, who I actually have no sword.
Why don't you do what you do best and warm up with some poetry?
Ah, yes.
I should challenge everyone to a duel so I can use my
life. Off we go to prepare our poetry for our death.
Now you can marry Isabella.
Macaroni.
But I was rendezvousing with thee, was I not?
My own way.
No, I was supposed to
not be mistaken like that.
I was supposed to be here with my love, like Isabella. You are obviously
not Isabella.
Come on, not yet! Come on, not yet!
You must. It was all just a joke. It was just so you would say nice things about me.
He's not dead.
So all those things that you said that you wanted to do with the money, we could just ignore them now.
No, we're still going to do that with the money.
But we had such a fine arrangement before.
I like this one now.
Dottore,
isn't there something about fraud in an arrangement like this? If one states that it won't happen, and
the party of the first part here, from known as the party of the first part, the party of the second part. All this writ has been registered legally with the judge. Can you expect me to rewrite this writ?
Well, perhaps not. Perhaps we could just let it be going the way you were. Son, you can learn the business. Come on, Isabella.
I will teach him how to be fine.
You gotta practice the money.
Just not worthy of someone as learned as you. In fact, Jomer Monsanto.
And I'm Sophia the Orange, and we have loved performing for you today. Thank you so much.